142 does kind of the same thing, but it's using your first and third fingers on both hands, which is a little more challenging for me because my third and fourth finger on this hand are really weak. So let me see if I can do it. Okay. And lick 143, of course, is isolating the first and the fourth finger on each hand, which is really hard for me to do because I got a weak pinky on this hand, on my picking hand. Okay, and that'll help you isolate. And you can also use your second and third on each hand, and your third and fourth, and that'll really strengthen those, doing the same type of thing. But that's lick 143. 144 is a tapping riff that just kind of gets the sequence going and keeps it going. Kind of a chromatic sequence. That's just a way to get a sequence going and keep it going. 45 is kind of a tapping sequence and a kind of a triplet type sequence. Lick 146 is a sequence that you use to work on your four-finger playing. It uses a three and a four-finger playing, but I started with a tap this time instead of a picking stroke. Alright. 147 is a tapping riff. It's really challenging to try to mute it. It goes across a couple different strings. It taps kind of like an arpeggio. Said really challenging to try to mute out the extra string noise. Lick number 148 is kind of like a tapping sequence. It's really challenging to do. These riffs are really hard for me to do, so bear with me. Lick 149 is kind of a tapping sequence I came up with to practice, like a forest pattern. That's lick 149. Lick number 150 is a little bit different of a tapping run. Pretty freaky. Lick 151 is just kind of a tapping sequence lick. You can put it on different strings. You get the idea.